Dear CBCP family, it's been a year since we've gathered in our Discipleship Center, and we still need to wait until it's safe to do so. But we won't let that stop us from celebrating our anniversary this year. That's right, on April 4, 9:30 a.m., we will celebrate on the same day at the same time. Tune in to our YouTube channel or our Facebook pages as a live premiere of our special anniversary worship service will be aired. We will praise and worship through songs, listen to the testimonies of our brothers and sisters, and respond to a special message to our church at this very unique time. Mark your calendars, that's April 4, 9:30 a.m. Let's worship and celebrate CBCP's anniversary dynamic at 34.
弟兄姊妹平安，今天是撒的二十一，是这个分地三的主日，能够做奉主的圣名撒及聚会。我这个真重要日子，请你记得，四个垂死，四个分头这个主日，那么撒及用这个网络 internet 的办法来庆祝咱的教会立会第三十四年，关上的祝福也教会。咱今日用诗篇一百空四篇三十三到三十四节来开始查经的聚会，咱读汉文及英文，请你跟我撒加来读，读汉文及英文。诗篇一百空四篇三十三到三十四节，圣经上你讲：我必以圣耶和华唱歌，我仍然活的时阵，不以五个上帝歌唱，关于以我的默念为甘地，我必因为耶和华欢喜。你来参加读英文 Psalms 104 33-34 I will sing to the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God as long as I live. May my meditation be pleasing to Him as I rejoice in the Lord.
clear the grave, release the lamb that was slain, release the king who conquered the grave. Lord of all creation, of water, earth, and sky, the heavens are your tabernacle. Glory to the Lord on high. God of wonders beyond our galaxy, you are holy, holy. The universe declares your majesty. You are holy, holy. Lord of heaven and earth, Lord of morning, I will celebrate the light. When I stumble into the darkness, I will call your name by night. God wonders beyond our galaxy. deserve, Lord of heaven and earth.
Peace, brothers and sisters.
Let's
continue our series from ruin to glory.
Today our
title is, Does the Lord see what is marvelous as what men regard as marvelous?
And
the passage can be found in
Zechariah 8:1-17.
We know that from Zechariah 7-8 is the third message that the prophet Zechariah
preached.
And this message, he talks about the four revelations from God.
And
in these four revelations, they talk about fasting and prayer. Today we will look at the third revelation, which can be found in chapter 8:1-17. But today I'll only speak until verse 11, because verses 12-17 will talk about the fourth revelation, and I'll talk about that next week. Let's first look at verse 6. This is what the Lord Almighty says. It may seem marvelous to the remnant of His people at that time, but will it seem marvelous to me, declares the Lord Almighty. Now, in this scripture, in this passage, marvelous appears twice. The Lord is asking, is what is marvelous in your eyes, is it also marvelous in my eyes? First, we must understand what matter is this he's talking about. And we'll see this in verses 4 to 5. Now this is what the Lord Almighty says. Once again, men and women of ripe old age will sit in the streets of Jerusalem, each of them with cane in hand because of their age. The city streets will be filled with boys and girls playing there. God told the Israelites, in the future, the streets of Jerusalem will be filled with old and young people
and old men.
And old men. Old people will be walking, they'll be playing chess, they'll be drinking. And little kids will be playing with each other. And this is a very festive and a joyous environment. But at the current time, it was not like this. Let's look at verse
14.
The land they left behind them was so desolate that no one traveled through it. This is how they made the pleasant land desolate. At the current time, Jerusalem was a desolate place. But God said, one day the streets will be filled with old and young men, and they will be joyously living together. And the Israelites asked, how could this be? How can this amazing and marvelous thing happen? So God said, what is marvelous for you may not be marvelous for me. Church. The way that God sees things is different from the way man sees things. Man only sees a part. God sees its entirety. Man only sees the past and the present. God sees the past, present, and the future. Currently, the whole world is facing the pandemic. It started around last year of January. Now the whole world is affected. The Philippines had a lockdown starting last year of March. It's already been 1 year. In the first 3 months, Metro Manila was like a ghost town.
没人也没灯,没有车也没人.
There was no men, there was no people, there were no cars.
其实不只是 Manila,
not only in Manila,
全世界都是这样的,
but also in the whole world.
包括法国、意大利、中国,
also in France, Italy, and China.
本来充满着游客这个出入的所在,
these are places that are full of tourists.
现在这个人都没有,
but now you will not find a single person.
那有过离境,
what if someone in 5 years ago?
有人说,
someone predicted that the whole world will be in lockdown.
我相信很多人心里说,
I believe a lot of us today would doubt him. But now it has happened. And many people think that this is quite an amazing thing that happened. We could not have expected this.
大家们, COVID-19 pandemic, 在上帝头前,
but let me ask you, was the pandemic really a surprise to God?
现在全世界落单, 在上帝目中,
was a global lockdown a surprise to God?
No.
No.
因为一切在上帝掌管的中间,
because this is all in the plans of God.
今天,
today,
这段经文中间,明白上帝三项大事,
in this passage, we'll talk about 3 things.
祂是奇妙的主, 祂是历史的主, 祂是施恩的主.
He is a wonderful Lord. He is the Lord of history, and He is the Lord of grace.
来来,说到头这项大事,
let's look at the first one.
祂是奇妙的主.
He is the wonderful Lord. When Zechariah preached this message, the nation of Israel was already destroyed. They had no nation. And Israel was scattered across the empire. But God stirred the heart of King Cyrus. He made him write an edict to allow the Jews to return to their homeland. Those who returned amounted to 50,000. And they later faced many opposition. They opposed the building of the temple for 16 years. During this time, Jerusalem was a place ravaged by war. There was no buildings. They had no money, no people. This was a desolate place. But God said, one day, the streets will be filled with the elderly and with the children. And this is an amazing thing. How can this thing happen? And the answer is found in verse
3.
This is what the Lord says. I will return to Zion and dwell in Jerusalem. Then Jerusalem will be called the faithful city, the mountain of the Lord. Almighty will be called the holy mountain.
I will return.
The Lord will return. Turns out God will return. And this amazing thing will happen again to Zion. So everything will be changed. Let's look at Isaiah 43:19. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland. Our God is a God who makes the wilderness, makes streams out of wilderness. He will make rivers out of the deserts. He is a wonderful God. Today the world is facing the pandemic.
其实圣经里面有真就安尼款的叫做灾难，就讲的疫情咧。
However, in the Bible, there's also periods of time when they had epidemics.
即就犹太人要出埃及的时阵
，such as when the Israelites were trying to leave Egypt.
因为面对这个法老的阻挡。
Because he faced the opposition of Pharaoh,
so 上帝降了十个灾在Egypt的里面。
God sent 10 plagues to Egypt.
其中一个灾
，one of these plagues，
叫做畜疫之灾
，was a plague on livestock.
那这个 plague of livestock 跟那个 COVID-19 哦有大不相啦。
Now this plague on livestock is very similar to COVID-19.
只不过这是对动物，不是对人。
But it only happens to animals, not to humans.
当时上帝将这个灾难临到全埃及。
When God sent this plague towards the entire of Egypt,
佮发生一件真奇妙的代志。
Something amazing happened.
你讲出来个记得九章第六节。
Let's look at Exodus 9:6.
伊讲埃及囊中的牲畜几乎拢死了，只是以色列的牲畜一只都无死啊。
All the livestock of the Egyptians died, but not one animal belonging to the Israelites died.
Not one animal died. 有以色列嘅动物无一只死啊。
Not one died.
这是何等奇妙嘅代志。
This was a very amazing thing.
因为奇妙上帝保护以色列人。
Because a God of wonders protected Israel.
你讲马家这是超度看么
？No, you might say this is a coincidence.
我再讲一个 example.
Let me give you another example.
我大声问你一个问题，你笑看咪
？Let me ask you a question.
拍战会死人呗
？Is there deaths in war?
无论是拍野的国家，还是拍输的国家，请问会死人呗
？Regardless in victory or in defeat, will people die in war?
Of course.
Of course.
这个世界无一个战争无死人的呀。
There is no war in this world without any casualties.
野死人，输的是死人。
The victor will have dead men. The loser will have dead men.
但是圣经里面有不拍一个战争。
But in the Bible, there was a battle.The victor did not lose a single person. And you might ask where? And this is found in Numbers 31. And this is the battle between the Israelites and the Midianites. Let us look at Numbers 31, 48-49.
It says, 当年秦军的国军长就是千户长、百户长，拢接近摩西，甲伊讲。木林关的兵已经计算过了，并无减少一个人。
Then the officers who were over the units of the army, the commanders of thousands and the commanders of hundreds, went to Moses and said to him, "Your servants have counted the soldiers under our command, and not one is missing."
你讲罗密切各位 ，and not one is missing.冇一个减少啊
！Not one was missing。
就可能啊
！How is this possible？
上帝奇妙嘅保护啊
！And this is the amazing protection of the Lord。
那个上帝是活嘅
，Our God is alive。
伊今日咧永远嘅奇妙嘅代志。
Today He makes wonderful things。
沙漠就将江河。
He will make the desolate into a land of prosperity。
我嚟看一个 picture。
Let me show you a picture。
你讲这个是两个相，这个是 before 1948， 这是 after 1948。
This is the city. This is the country of Israel before 1948 and after 1948.
Before 1948, 是以色列人未复国以前。
Before 1948, this was before Israel settled back into the Promised Land.
以色列已经亡国了。
And the country of Israel was already in ruins.
整个 Promised Land 变成一个沙漠的所在 ，desert 的所在。
Now Israel was now a desert.
什么都冇。
There was nothing there.
你讲连树木、连树都冇。
If you look, there is no vegetation.
你讲 after 1948.
Look at after 1948.
当以色列复国以后。
When Israel became a nation again,
上帝做一个奇妙的代志。
God made wonders.
佢怎么将沙漠榨出江河
？He made the desert become a river.
真就树木出来了。
Many vegetation came out.
不奇妙不
？This is amazing.
你个看另外一个 picture.
Look another picture.
It's the same before 1948 and after 1948.
It's the same.
上帝是奇妙的上帝。
Our God is amazing God.
教会
，Church。
那个上帝是真奇妙 ，wonderful。
Our God is truly wonderful。
在上帝里面，那就有盼望。
In Him we have hope。
在上帝里面，那就有改变。
In Him change can happen。
在人看是稀奇的代志。
What is marvelous in the eyes of men？
在上帝看起是真普通。
It's quite ordinary in the eyes of God。
因为伊是靠技术的上帝。
Because He is the God who makes wonders happen。The second, He is the Lord of history. Our God is a God of history. Some will say history is His story.
This
is actually true.
咱的上帝对这个世界有一个计划。
Our God has a plan for this world. No matter who you are, no matter what power, whether it is the power of the world, such as political power or military, or even in the spiritual, such as demons and evil spirits, none of these things can change the plan of God. Because our God is sovereign. His plan cannot be changed. Let's look at Zechariah
8:2.
This is what the Lord Almighty says. I am very jealous for Zion. I am burning with jealousy for her. God said he is very jealous for Zion.
He's
saying that he will restore this place of Zion in Israel. That's why it happens in the future.
In the verse 4.
In verse
4.
That in the future, the streets will be filled with the elderly and with the children playing and drinking. In the eyes of men, this is quite a marvelous thing. But God says this is not marvelous. Let me ask you a question. If I tell you, if I tell you in the future, the Philippines will be the number one country in the world, the richest country, the strongest country, and have top-notch citizens. I don't know if you'll think that it's marvelous. But what if I didn't say these things? What if the Lord of History said these things? Then I'll tell you, this will not be marvelous. Because no one can change his history. Today, I would like to explain to you very simply the history of Israel. In 2000 BC, God called Abraham. God said to him, I will make you a great nation. I will make your name great. Everyone on the earth will be blessed because of you. God wants to use Abraham and his descendants to be a blessing for all nations. He will give him the land of Canaan. But he said, you will have to wait 400 years. The Lord arranged Abraham's descendants to live in Egypt for 430 years. When the time came, God sent Moses to bring Israel out of Egypt. Then in 1400 BC, Joshua led the Israelites into Canaan. In 1050 BC, Israel had their first king, Saul. In
930
BC, the nation was divided into two kingdoms. The northern kingdom was Israel, the southern was Judah. But in 721 BC, Israel was destroyed by Assyria.
And
the southern kingdom, Judah, was defeated by Babylon in 606 BC. And many was taken captive into Babylon. One of the most famous is Daniel. But God, who is in control of history, said that the Jews will return after 70 years of captivity. And now in 536 BC, King Cyrus sent the Israelites back home.
重建圣殿,
to rebuild the temple.
对大以后,
from that point onwards, was under the rule of the Persian Empire.
直到罗马帝国兴起来,
until the rise of the Roman Empire.
在主后70年,
and in 70 AD,
罗马将军提刀攻击耶路撒冷,
General Titus broke through Jerusalem,
毁坏了圣殿,
and he destroyed the temple.
犹太人重新分散万国的中间,
and the Jews were once scattered again.
后来出现了阿列伯帝国这个出现,
later on an Arab empire rose,
统治了整个中东的所在,
and it conquered the entire Middle East,
甚至在圣殿的所在, 建立这个回教的 temple,
and on the Temple Mount they built a mosque.
后来发生了
And after many years, many crusades happened. By then, the Jews already lost Canaan. But the God of history is still the Lord of history. After the First World War, the United Kingdom conquered the land of Palestine.
后来同意让犹太人重新到来建立这个民族的国家。
The United Kingdom approved the return of the Jewish people back to their nation.
结果在1948年9月14日, 英国停止对巴勒斯坦的管理。
And on May 14, 1948, Britain terminated its mandate on Palestine, and Israel became an established nation.
So in 1948, 犹太人正式复国。
Now in 1948, the country of Israel was established again.
但是复国以后,
however, after its establishment,
耶比头和以色列和约旦和黎巴嫩和以色列各国家来攻破这以色列。
Its neighbors formed a coalition to fight against him in Egypt, in Syria, Jordan, Lebanon, and Iraq.
但是以色列成功将各国家打下去。
But Israel was able to defeat them.
结果犹太人说不要打了。
And United Nations declared a ceasefire.
后来发生几个星期的战争。
Later on, several other wars broke out.
第一出名是1967年6月最高的6日的战争。
One of the most famous happened on June 5, 1967, the Six-Day War.
以色列将被头隆中阿拉伯的国家隆中打下去。
Israel defeated the surrounding Arabian countries in 6 days.
将要控制这个Air Force的力量隆中打下去。
Israel defeated their air force,
收了真多的territory到来,
and they were able to recapture a large amount of territory.
直到今日,
to this day,
以色列是越来越强大,
Israel gets stronger and stronger,
无论是经济里面, 医学里面, 军事里面,
whether economically, medically, or militarily.
教会,
church,
在历史里面从来没有一个国家亡国过百年以后有通复国的,
there's never been a nation in history that's been restored 500 years after its destruction. And Israel has been conquered for 1,500 years.
In 1948,
yet in 1948, they were re-established.
这个不是人的工作,
this is not the work of man.
这是上帝的工作,
this is the work of God.
因为是这个掌管历史的上帝,
for he is a God who rules history.
英国一个真正出名的历史学家, Toynbee说了一句话,
an English historian named Arnold Toynbee,
他说历史是上帝创造物件头前走的环境。
He says history is a vision of God's creation on the move.
历史发生所有的事情都是照上帝所看到的事情来前进。
Everything that happens in history works according to God's vision.
教会现在全世界面对这个COVID-19 pandemic的问题。
Church, as the world is facing this pandemic,
你哪知道上帝不知道吗?
Do you think God does not know?
你哪知道上帝没掌管吗?
Do you think God will not do anything about it?
上帝真早就知道呀。
God already knows.
2020, 全世界有这个 COVID-19 pandemic的情况。
God already knows that in 2020, a pandemic would occur.
因为历史是照上帝所安排的事情继续发生下去。
Because history moves according to his vision.
他是掌管一切的上帝。
He is a God who is sovereign.
他是历史的主宰。
He is the God of history.
如何讲的事?
The last,
他是施恩的主。
He is the Lord of grace.
你看撒加利亚书第8章第7到第8节。
Let's look at verses 7 to 8.
万军的耶和华说，我要对东方、西方、教会国的百姓，我要从他那里，让他站在耶路撒冷中间，他要做我的主民。 我要做伊个上帝，拢凭着诚实甲公义。
This is what the Lord Almighty says. I will save my people from the countries of the east and the west. I will bring them back to live in Jerusalem. They will be my people, and I will be faithful and righteous to them as their God.
第四节讲到将来耶路撒冷归路，充满了许多人，充满了金啊。
In verse 4, it talks about the streets of Jerusalem being filled with the elderly and the children.
这样代志，何人感觉真稀奇
？For many, this is a marvelous thing.
但是讲一点啊都不稀奇。
But God says not a single thing is amazing.
为什么啊
？Why is this？
答案是第七第八节。
The answer is in verse 7 and 8.
因为上帝要重新施恩乎以色列人。
Because it is the Lord who will show this grace to His people.
将犹太人对东方西方隆重救到来。
He will rescue them from the east all to the west.
乎犹太人国就要查做上帝主民。
And Israel will be again His people.
上帝就是上帝。
And He will be their God.Again.
这叫做关系的恢复。
And this is a restoration of their relationship.
上帝重新施恩乎犹太人。
God will once again show mercy to Israel.
当咱在做咩思想犹太人历史的时阵
，As we reflect on the history of Israel,
早犹太人离开迦南地到亡国只有900里的时间。
From the time of their entrance into Canaan to their destruction, 900 years has passed.
在900年里面
，In those 900 years，
伊一摆一摆犯罪
，They sinned again and again，
包括宗教顶面的罪、道德顶面的罪
，They would commit religious or moral sins，
伊拜偶像
，They would worship idols，
拜假神
，They would
what false god，
They would false god，
worship the false god，
They would worship false gods，
用假礼来献祭。
And they would sacrifice their children.
犯了淫乱的罪。
And they would commit adultery.
杀人的罪。
And they would commit murder.
偷盗的罪。
They would steal.
简单来讲哦。
Simply put,
就是十诫里面无一条遵守就对了。
They did not follow any of the Ten Commandments.
按我哋百姓及上帝的圣洁、公义、慈爱完全无损。
So they have not. They're totally in contrary to the holiness of God.
所以未配地称作上帝嘅儿女。
So they are not worthy to be His people.
但系上帝讲
，But God said，
我要将佢重新救到嚟。
I will rescue them.
伊要徛喺耶路撒冷嘅里面。
And they will once again live in Jerusalem. 伊
要做我嘅主民。
They will be my people.
我要做伊嘅上帝。
I will be their God.
你讲真有可能啊
？And you will say, how can this be?
Yes， 这个叫做恩典 grace。
Yes， this is grace。
主要说你世界世界嘅时阵
，When Jesus was still alive，
伊讲到一个parable 叫做浪子的故事。
He said a parable。
这个浪子哦，伊讲家己知影，伊未配得称作伊老爸的囝。
In the story, in the parable of the prodigal son, the son knows that he is not worthy of his father's love。
伊老爸伊受过歹了，伊感觉老爸唔应该我接纳伊了啦。
He clearly knew that he was very evil, that his dad would no longer accept him。
所以对老爸讲。
So he told his father,
I'm
not worthy to be your son. Just let me be your servant. But the father kissed him. He gave him the best robe. He put upon him a signet ring. He killed the fattened calf. As if this son has made a great achievement.
你讲为什么安尼啊
？And you might ask why？
因为浪子的故事的主角，渣渣不是浪子啊。
Because the real hero of this story is not the son，
是浪子的老爸。
But is the father of this prodigal son？
我哋也出名的牧师叫做 Timothy Keller， 写了一卷册。
A famous pastor named Timothy Keller wrote a book。
伊名叫做 Prodigal God。
The name of the book is Prodigal God。
唔是 Prodigal Son， 是 Prodigal God。
Not Prodigal Son， but Prodigal God。
但是有人将这个 Prodigal God 翻作汉语叫做挥霍的上帝。
But oh, it was translated into the Chinese, which meant that he was an extravagant God.
那这个 in the Chinese name 有两个意思。
Now there's two meanings in the Chinese。
这个挥霍的上帝，那。因为骨仙哦，就是已经慷慨，伊那是个歹意思，是真够开支。
So in a good sense, he would be extravagant and generous. In a bad sense, he would be spending a lot of money. He would be not thrifty.
当然，咱就要
But as we know, that this represents the generosity of God. Even though he does not deserve it, he will give it still.
This
is called grace.
So recovering the heart of Christian faith.
So the subtitle was recovering the heart of the Christian faith. No, the father of the prodigal son represents our heavenly father. Israel was not worthy of his salvation. But God saved them.
请问,
let me ask.
咱能配得上帝拯救吗?
Are we worthy?
咱不是不配得,
we are not worthy.
上帝不是一摆一摆拯救咱,
God has forgiven us again and again.
赦免咱,
and he has saved us.
教会,
church.
请问,
let me ask you.
为什么人你心里,
is there anyone in your life right now that you cannot forgive? God has forgiven you. Because he is a loving and a just God.
Forgive the others.
So you must forgive others. Surrender it into his hands. Grace itself is a wonderful thing. Grace is getting something that you do not deserve. I've heard a very good explanation about grace. That grace is God's love in action.
God's love in action.
Grace will take action. It happens to those who do not deserve it. So when you show others grace, this person is unworthy to receive it. So in the eyes of others, this is a marvelous thing. This person does not deserve it, yet why do you give it to him? Because this is grace. Last year, the church gave me a list. This was the list of our staff in our housekeeping, in our drivers.
He
said, apart from the 13th month, is it okay for us to give an additional 10,000 or 20,000 pesos? Because last year, it was not easy for them. They experienced difficulty. Of course, I did not disagree to this.
God's love in action.
Because grace is God's love in action. Our Lord is the Lord of grace. Church. Today we have learned that our God is a wonderful God. We must trust him. Because everything is in his hands. We learn that he is a God of history. Not only does he control world history, he controls you and my history. So we must put him in his rightful place. He is our God.
Let God be God.
And lastly, we have learned he is the Lord of grace. Not only have we received his grace, we must also practice giving grace to others.
Let us
be a channel of blessing. Praise God. May God bless us. Bless our church.
Let's pray. Thank you. Amen. 是这个罗马这边的信息，讲到 from ruin to glory， 也是罗马这个信息讲到金价几多的代志。那礼拜来结束这个 series message， 那礼拜告诉大家 ，God bless you。